You are now tuned into the truth frequency.
We are TFR. TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
From the biggest little city in the world in the clear blue waters of Lake Tahoe, broadcasting from an undisclosed location in the Truckee River Valley on Truth Frequency Radio, this is the Awakening Liberty Show with Sean Caron. We have all been exposed. As you all know, all of us here on True Frequency Radio are charlatan shamans, shills, new agers, kumbaya communists, anarchist hillbillies, Illuminati, and Freemason insiders who all have very expensive microphones. All of which, by the way, are built in China by corporations that utilize forced child labor and engage in human sex trafficking. What a load of poppycock and gobbledygook. Thanks for the publicity, you wanker. That bit inspired by the Truth Frequency troll on YouTube who posted a very derogatory review of Truth Frequency Radio on YouTube. If you haven't heard it yet, I'm sure you're going to. It absolutely is hysterical, uninformed, and he obviously hasn't listened to probably a single show on Truth Frequency Radio. But as we all know, us in the truth business, we do get our trolls, and we do get our people who just basically want to denigrate us for any reason because they just don't you know what, they're brainwashed, they're indoctrinated, and they're full of the propaganda. So it's very funny to see. I mean, some of the attacks that I receive for doing what I do are just absolutely hilarious. I wish they would just stop paying attention to those dumb phones. But I'm not even going to give the channel out, but you can actually go to awakeningliberty show.com on Facebook. And I did post the video there, and it also is on Truth Frequency Radio's page on Facebook as well, our like page. So stop by, give us a like, my page and Truth Frequency Radio. Check out the video. It's absolutely hysterical. But I had to laugh, man. I was it just was very, very funny. So anyway, welcome to the Awakening Liberty Show. It's great to be back behind my very expensive microphone today, as I do every Saturday and Sunday at 2 p.m. Pacific time. Like I said, great to be back. I want to mention the Awakening Liberty Show website, revamped. I got a full schedule and a full calendar of all my upcoming guests. Stop by, say hi, and I also wanted to mention, in partnership with L.A. Marzulli, who's been on the show a couple times. You guys have all heard that show. The Awakening Liberty Show is proud to be partnershiped with him. We are an affiliate, and L.A. Marzulli is running a special promotion. So check out the Awakening Liberty Show website. That's awakeninglibertyshow.com, and get Watchers 10. So you're going to get Watchers 10. You're going to get Nephilim hybrids. You're going to get Communion CD, a one-year subscription to Politics, Prophecy, and the Supernatural, which is a $24 value. And you're going to get Watchers 3, Fingerprints of the Supernatural. So it's a big combo pack. It retails for about $93. The Awakening Liberty Show special L.A. Marzulli is available at awakeninglibertyshow.com. You can pick up all of that for $39.99 plus shipping and handling. What a bargain. Get your L.A. Marzulli swag because he's doing some great stuff. I love L.A. I've loved having him on the show. So again, awakeninglibertyshow.com. Get the Awakening Liberty Show special promotion today. Also, real quick, I got put in Facebook jail the other day. And you can check out my like page again at Awakening Liberty Show, at Awakening Liberty Show on Facebook, and Sean Caron, obviously, on my personal page. But I got put in Facebook jail the other day, and I'm out now. I hollered, and they went ahead and got me going again. But I kind of moved over to Sue. And if you haven't checked out Sue, I would recommend that you do. Sue is a new social platform that actually pays you to use the platform to like, share, comment, post. It's great. You can check out my network over there. It is Sue, as in tsunami, tsu.com/Awakening Liberty Show. Again, tsu.co/Awakening Liberty Show. Come join the network. And just so you know, it's not some sort of scam, okay? My wife and I have actually cashed out $922 in a year and a half by using a social media network. We get $100 pretty often, so you can cash out when you reach $100. So again, tsu.co/Awakening Liberty Show. Come join my network. I'll help you get started. I'll show you all the tips and tricks to getting your network going and actually starting to make money on Sue. Also, YouTube is doing really well. We surpassed 1,400 subscribers. Actually, we're about 1,450 right now, and that's great to see. Thank you for all the love and support. I want to thank ODD for being on the show last week. Odd TV, this is crazy, man. Coincidence for sure, but ODD TV, Odd TV, was taken down and terminated by YouTube the day after the show I did with him last week. And that was Saturday. So they took his whole channel down on Sunday. And we're talking 40,000 subscribers Odd TV has, ODD TV. But I wanted to thank him for being on the show. And you can go and check that out on YouTube, because we actually inserted all of the music we tried to play here on the show last week. And we weren't able to, because for some reason or another, Skype didn't want us to play those clips. But you can go listen to the show. Again, Awakening Liberty Show on YouTube. Just look it up, ODD TV. And it was a great show. I want to thank him for being on the show. I got a couple news things I want to go over today first, but we are going to have a great guest today. I'm really excited today, again, to welcome Dr. Joye back to the show. She is, first of all, a very sweet person, and I'm really looking forward to talking to her again. She's done so much as far as her research goes, and I think you're all going to get a kick out of what she does. I mean, she's an author, a researcher, a counselor, and she's received numerous awards for her work with the handicapped and was heavily involved in the Georgia Special Olympic programs. So she's going to be joining us today. I'm going to be talking about a couple of her books. One is the series Beguiled, and the other one is going to be Eden, The Knowledge of Good and Evil, 666, Prepare for the Antichrist. So it's going to be very interesting to talk to Dr. Joye again today. But first, I got a couple things I want to go over. Again, last week, you know, I had Tom Hoefling on. He's America Party's 2016 nomination for president. And, I have to say, I was very astounded by him. And I hate to say this, but I think I probably wasted his time, because people who listened to the show last week, certainly Tom did not garner any support from myself or the listeners out there. You know, he has some great deals. I mean, he's obviously fighting abortion. He's talking about smaller government. But when it came to the tough questions like geoengineering and chemtrails and 9/11, he just, I was so astounded that he did not have any clue that millions and millions of Americans are concerned about things like 9/11. I mean, there are thousands, tens of thousands of architects and engineers, pilots, firefighters, cops, all who were involved, all who looked at the situation, and all have questions and have realized that the official narrative is garbage. But he buys the whole thing hook, line, and sinker. And, I got to cut him a little slack, because I did too. I mean, up until 2005, 2006, I thought the whole thing was exactly as they told us it happened. But those of us who are in the know today know that's not the case. But like I said, I was completely astounded how out of touch he was. And then when it came to the Constitution, you know, I don't want to keep hammering this, but I'm starting to have problems with the document. Because it's looking like we the people have become we the problem. I mean, how can we continue to support a Constitution that allowed things like this infanticide, that allows organizations like the ACLU and the National Man-Boy Love Association, otherwise known as NAMBLA, and other organizations that promote pedophilia as a sexual orientation as opposed to the abomination and abuse that it is? I mean, have we the people become we the problem? Is the immorality got so far out of control that we feel like we can impose our will versus God's will or the will of Yahweh? I mean, look at our country. How well is this Constitution and this document actually working for us? Not very well. That is clear to me. Now, either the document has problems or those entrusted by oath to protect said document have problems. That's a certainty. But of course, all of this is all by design. I mean, the con of the Constitution, I mean, this document may have been written this way on purpose to impose the kind of immorality that we see in our country, to impose illegal wars, to impose imperial fascism, to impose things like we saw this week regarding Hillary Clinton and the FBI. I'm going to get into that in a minute. But I wanted to thank Tom for coming on the show because I felt like I wasted his time, but I don't feel like I wasted my listeners' time because my third-party candidate exposure series is about exposing the candidates. So at least the listeners got to hear from him and see that he was not really in touch with the American people. I wish him the best of luck. And I regret. I wanted to ask him one question. I really wish I had asked him a question. Which was, if you did get to the White House, if you were elected, which I don't believe anybody's being elected, I believe it's being appointed, but if you were to get there and you found out that 9/11, that there was more to that story, would you blow the whistle? If you found out geoengineering and chemtrails and solar radiation management and SAI programs were real, would you blow the whistle? I wish I'd have asked him that. But I didn't, and that's life, and that's hindsight. So real quick, I'm running out of time here because I want to get Dr. Joye on. I really want to get to her. But I got to talk about this whole news story with Hillary Clinton. I mean, and the Clinton Crime Foundation. The aristocracy of the ruling class parasites, the oligarchy and the tyrannical, odious sycophants that have hijacked this country. They've hijacked the whole world. I mean, there's no way of getting around this. According to Director James Comey, Hillary Clinton checked every box required for a felony violation of Section 793 of the Federal Penal Code, Title 18, with lawful access to highly classified information. She acted with gross negligence in removing and causing it to be removed from its proper place of custody. And she transmitted it and caused it to be transmitted to others not authorized to have it. It's a patent violation of her trust. Now, Director Comey even conceded that former Secretary Clinton was extremely careless and suggested strongly that her recklessness very likely led to communications being intercepted by foreign intelligence services. Yet, the FBI and the director recommended against prosecution of the law violations. He clearly found on the ground that there was no intent to harm the United States. So in essence, ladies and gentlemen, in order to give Ms. Clinton a pass, and they had to give her a pass. I've been saying on the show for 6 months now that Hillary Clinton would be the next president of the United States because I don't believe we are in a situation where the election process is real. She has been bred, groomed, and she will be placed into office. Now, I'm just waiting. Maybe I'm wrong. But this whole FBI ruling sort of confirms the fact that there is a fix, that the fix is in, that Ms. Clinton, Mrs. Clinton, who knows, whatever you want to call her, is going to be the next president of the United States. They inserted an intent element that Congress does not require. The added intent element, moreover, makes no sense. The point of having a statute that criminalizes gross negligence is to underscore that government officials have a special obligation to safeguard national defense secrets. And when they fail to carry that out, to take care of that obligation, they are guilty of serious wrongdoing. We are in a situation in this country, folks, where the law applies to the plebes, but not to the ruling class parasites. And this stuff has got to stop. People need to wake up. As I said in last week's show, I encourage people to still go out and vote. I didn't want to vote this time, but I am going to go vote for third party. And I think if more people do that in mass and stop voting within this false left-right, wacko, satanic, Luciferian paradigm, that we might be actually able to affect some change. So that's my rant for the day. I am going to bring Dr. Joye on here. I am so looking forward to talking to Dr. Joye again. Are you there? Dr. Joye, are you there?
Yes. How are you doing today?
I am outstanding, Doctor. How is everything going with you?
Well, we still having some issues, but every day is a blessed day, so I look forward to doing what the Lord has needs to be done.
Yeah, sorry, I clicked the wrong button there. I don't know if you heard something, but I was trying to increase your volume because you're a little bit low, but I actually placed you on hold. Doing what the Lord, you know, doing His will is what we're all about. So, you know, I know that you have had some issues with your husband. The last time we talked, you said he's very, very sick. Is he doing better at all?
Well, no, not really. We have an ongoing problem that really surfaced from a flu shot, so... This vaccination programs that are pushed all over the world as doing a very safe thing really caused our problem back in the latter part of December of 2008, and it's just been a slowly decline because of the neurological problems that having something like that does to a person. We're never told really the truth about what we're being given, and at the time, I guess I was more worried about him not taking a flu shot because I didn't want him to get the flu. But instead, it set up a GBS, a Guillain-Barré syndrome, that turned into a chronic inflammatory demyelinating polyneuropathy. And did not catch us what had happened, could not find anybody that would be willing to come forward and try to figure out what was wrong. And so we went for about 3.5 years before he was finally diagnosed that the flu shot had, in fact, been the culprit to the deterioration that has caused his body. So... it's something we've had to deal with, and anyone ever has anyone that deals with people who have neurological damage, I mean, it just goes after everything from your swallowing to your breathing, your mind, to your body's ability to move. And so it's forced us to make a lot of changes in our life where, you know, a perfect, healthy man who was playing golf every day and had worked sometimes 7 days a week for years on end, blown all around the world, takes a flu shot, and within 2 weeks can't feed himself, can't roll over, can't do anything. So our life became a whole different setup, and we have had to deal with it. And because of the condition, it brings on a lot of other issues that you have to deal with as well. So I appreciate you asking about him. But, you know, like what you were talking about earlier, sometimes the truth about what's really being done to us is never told. I had never heard of anything of this nature happening to anyone, and was not even aware that the flu shot could present a type of problem that he has. And then the more you find out, you find a lot of people who have had the flu shot have not only had this thing happen to them, but maybe set up things like Bell's palsy and other types of neurological dysfunctions, and never really understand to tie it back to the fact that they had a flu shot maybe 2 weeks or 3 weeks beforehand. So it's been a transition for us, and you know, I appreciate the people that are out there that know about our situation, the prayers that they have lifted up for us, because with me trying to do the research that I do, I'm very blessed that you have asked me to be on your show and other people asked me to be on the show, that I'm able to do this, you know, live, and to do it from a home, because there was a time, you know, that I could go and do conferences and do speeches and do teachings in various places, and, you know, be on TV and things like that. But now, because of his condition, I have to be here to be able to look after him. So God provides, and I'm thankful for you. I'm thankful for the show that you have and the opportunity to be able to talk about my research, because I feel like that all the things that I believe that are happening today, and the hardships that especially Christians seem to be going through, and the world and how it's changing, is very much spoken of in, you know, biblical context. And I think in the past, people, you know, always wanted to look and push aside possibility of end times. I think some people did it because they didn't want to deal with the fact that that could ever happen because of what the Bible was telling us would occur during that time for fear. But at the same time, I think people sometimes read and they don't really understand and are fearful to maybe bring the reality of what is occurring all around us and see that it does line up specifically to everything that our Bible has told us is going to happen. And it seems that the more you study this and the closer you get to understanding it and the more you get into the Word, it's not like a lot of people believe that once they have been a very bad person, all of a sudden they decide to become a Christian, that the world's just going to be laid out to them and they're going to get a Mercedes in their garage like some people preach. It's just the opposite. The more that you understand Satan and the game that's being played, and the more you expose it, and the more he attacks you.
Yeah, absolutely.
And
experienced that myself.
And my life, you know, has been that. I mean, I honestly have had to do most all of the research and things that I've ever done under great duress. It started with my mother with her cancer that really brought me to the table to sit down and start writing, because before that time I just worked, you know, I was very involved with a lot of things going on in my life. And she was the one that would always say, you know, Joy, I feel like that God has put you in prison so that you will do his work. You're kind of, she would say that I reminded her of Paul, and that that I had the knowledge of a lot of things, but I was so busy doing all the things that I wasn't really maybe focusing on what he needed for me to do. And so he took me out of the world of work and forced me to look after her and my grandmother, who were very, very ill before my husband got sick. And I would do my research while my mother was taking cancer treatments all day. I would do all my reading, and then at night, once I got everybody to sleep, I'd stay up all night and type. So my books have been a very much a labor of love and what I believe was a calling, because many people would say, well, how in the world did you go like for days and days and weeks and months with no sleep? And I would tell them that it was awfully strange that around the 1 or 2 o'clock time period, I would maybe get a little bit tired, but after the 3 o'clock point of night, it would almost be that I would get this amazing little energy that seemed to sustain me, and it would sustain me all into the next day and the next days and the next days. I don't think that was me. I fully believe that was the Holy Spirit that was taking control. And many times I go back and I look at the research, the enormous amount of research that I've done, and I have thought, had these sicknesses not been a part of, you know, my everyday life, I would have never taken the time to have done all, or could have done all the research that I've done, because I was very involved with working with the mentally and physically disabled. That was a very big calling for me, and I would spend 24/7 helping other people who had very serious situations and trying to make lives better within the realm of this reality, because so many people don't realize how hard it is when a person has a handicapped family member, never dreaming that I would end up with 3 very handicapped family members.
Yeah.
And, you know, and it prepared me for doing that, but at the same time, I knew that even though I've got these things, I can still continue to do, because God will open other doors if you look on, well, what am I going to do? What is he wanting me to do? And I try to tell people that we are not just a little grain of sand floating out in infinity. We're all here for a major purpose. We are in God's image, and we all have a major, major calling. And I know last week I found out that the lady that wrote my foreword for my Beguile series was one of my, I guess, best research buddies, I guess if I could say, at a distance, because we never met face-to-face. Everything we did was on the phone. She was not into the Internet at all. She did not trust Internet information, and sometimes, I hate to say it, I don't trust it too much either, because I get really excited when I see something and then find out, you know, that it's not true, that somebody's made it all up. But she was an avid reader of true and books that she could get her hands on and do research on. And so, she told me, she said,
hold on a second. We're going to be coming up on a break here, and we're going to talk about Beguiled, because that book to me is called Beguiled, Eden to Armageddon. We're going to be talking about that. But I first wanted to say that thank you so much for sharing your personal vaccine injury story with us, because so many of my listeners know how passionate I am about the vaccine truth movement. The movie Vaxxed is out. I feel vindicated to some degree, because not only do I know someone like you who has experienced it, I know four families who now have children who have experienced damage by vaccines. And this agenda is completely out of hand. And so thank you so much again for sharing that with us, because, again, many people listening know that, you know, I'm going to have Dr. Gwen Olson on the show. I've had Dr. Judy Mikovits, Ken Heckenlively, The Age of Autism, Rima Labow, Barbara Lowe Fisher, the NVIC. It is so important for people to realize that even a simple flu shot can do this type of serious damage, not only to your loved ones, but then to your family. It just goes on and on. And I pray for you every day, Dr. Joye, and I pray for all of the families that I know and all of the children that I know who have been injured by vaccines, because this is a very, very difficult situation to deal with. So, again, thank you so much for sharing that. We're coming up on a break here real quick. Are you there?
Yes.
Okay. Did you hear me?
That you're coming up on a break. I didn't know whether you wanted me to wait and you were going into break.
Oh, no, we're going to go into a break here real quick. I just wanted to say that, and my prayers are with you and Mel for certain. When we come back, folks, we're going to be talking about Dr. Joye's book, Beguiled, Eden to Armageddon, along with Eden, The Knowledge of Good and Evil, 666, Prepare for the Rise of the Antichrist. We're going to be looking at all the biblical prophecy and what's going on in the world. So stay tuned. The Awakening Liberty Show. We'll be right back.
No hype, no fear.
You're listening to Truth Frequency Radio.
We are TFR.
I'll bust it one time. Truth and liberty. Fight the new world order and the tyranny. The Awakening Liberty Show with Sean Caron.
And welcome back to the Awakening Liberty Show right here on Truth Frequency Radio. Forgive me, I'm laughing at these troll ads. Chris Geo has been up to no good, obviously, getting really creative with this troll ad that came off of YouTube. Those are absolutely hilarious. Obviously, this uninformed guy, you know, we've all been exposed as charlatans and shamans and shills. It's just good grief. But Chris, you're doing a great job with this guy and what he did on YouTube as far as being derogatory to all of us. And again, I'm back behind my very expensive microphone. Just hilarious stuff. You guys are all going to hear that. So anyway, welcome back to the Awakening Liberty Show right here on truthfrequencyradio.com, all across America, all around the world. The number to call in is 866-37-TRUTH. Again, that number is 866-378-7884. So if you have a question or comment for myself or for my guest, Dr. Joye, feel free to call in and join the conversation. Dr. Joye, again, I wanted to thank you. We had some sort of weird sound issue. I thought I lost you there when I was talking. So I wanted to thank you again for sharing your vaccine injury story and about your husband. And again, my prayers are with you and your family at all times. I hope that this gets better for you. And, you know, we're all in a position where we have to endure things. And I hope God gives you the strength to do that.
Well, he really has. And thank goodness. But I will tell you that the days and nights get very long when you're dealing with something as serious as this gets. And, you know, sometimes you can arrest some of the, you know, problem that you have if it's caught early. But in our case, everybody didn't want to, you know, they did not want to acknowledge. And that's the problem. And, you know, the CDC wants to push the fact that it's the greatest thing since peanut butter for everybody to have these vaccinations. Nobody wants to hear that these things happen. So the few that have to suffer for the greater, say, maybe good of mankind, are the ones like my husband who has had to suffer, you know, his entire hope for retirement in a chair watching the golf that he always wanted to play. So it's a pretty rough thing to have to deal with when you think about if the truth had been told about these things, then maybe such circumstances could have been, you know, avoided. And like I say, when these neurologists actually come to terms with it, and then you start talking to them, they do sometimes the staff especially will share with you about the numbers of children that are coming in that they have known all their life that, you know, were not having a problem, and then all of a sudden they took this series of shots and now they're all autistic. So because I worked with, you know, autism and those types of things, I saw the increase in the numbers after we started doing these massive, you know, vaccination programs. So I think a lot of people who especially are older that have been diagnosed with probably something like Parkinson's disease, that if they have been diagnosed, they need to go back and think, did those particular manifestations start within 2 to 3 to 4 weeks after they had a flu shot? Because I think a lot of people are being treated for Parkinson's that do not have Parkinson's, and they're dying because the medication that they're giving them is a very, can be a very serious thing, and the truth will never be known. So I think a lot of people who, and you hear it all the time, people coming down everywhere you turn with Parkinson's disease, I think are actually victims of flu shots. And if I had a loved one, after I know what has happened in my case with Mel, that you need to be trying to figure out, did someone in your family before the Parkinson's just hit all of a sudden? Because they try to say that was going on when it was not. Parkinson's is a very, it's not a quick, you don't go from being a perfectly normal person walking and doing fine to one that cannot move. So if you've been diagnosed like that and you're listening to the program and you've had a flu shot, I would suggest that you know, need to go back to your doctor and have a spinal tap done to see exactly what's going on. It's a terrible thing, and I appreciate the opportunity to explain about it because I feel that, you know, unless people know that there are cases and you can hear about a true case, it's no different than the work that I do when I've done research. If I have not had a true case to deal with, that makes it harder. It's just kind of a book knowledge. But when you have had hands-on every day and seen how the manifestation happens and what occurs and then how doctors don't want to own up to it and are afraid to own up to it because of fear of license, you know, being revolt and whatever, if they start telling people don't do it. It's a very sad situation, so I'm glad that your program has been one to kind of open the door to allowing people like myself to talk about it, as well as the people that you've asked that are the expertise, you know, in those particular fields, because it is a definite problem. And I really do believe that there are a lot of people walking around thinking that they have Parkinson's and it really came from their flu shot, if they go back and think when their symptoms started and how soon after the flu shot did they start. And I would really highly recommend that people who are diagnosed that they really, if they have had a flu shot before those symptoms started, that they need to be trying to find out the real truth about what's wrong with them.
Well, and the CDC is complicit. Obviously, Big Pharma and the vaccine manufacturers have got them under their wing and, you know, I want to say bought and paid for, but even Congress is bought and paid for. They're ignoring the fact. I mean, we got a Dr. William Thompson out there who's a CDC whistleblower saying, yes, we have known for a long time that vaccines are causing autism. We've got Judy Mikovits saying she found XMRV retroviruses that cause cancer within the vaccines and the blood supply. You know, they gag ordered her. This is an agenda, obviously, for money. It's not about patients. It's not about people. It's not about our health and welfare. And then, you know, Robert De Niro, bless his heart, he has a child with autism. And the whole thing that he did, he was thinking just like the enemy. He pulled Vaxxed from Tribeca Film Festival. He did that on purpose because what happened next? Vaxxed went viral, and it's all over the country now, and doctors are watching it, the same doctors you're talking about who aren't trained. They don't know. They don't realize. They're so compartmentalized that they don't understand the vaccines are causing injuries like your husband has, like my four friends' children have. It's all over the place. I mean, autism is, Dr. Joye, 1 in 39 kids. They say by 2025 it's going to be 1 in 2.
Well, you know, and look at the numbers of cases with Parkinson's and how that has increased. Like I say, I do believe that the older generation is coming down with Parkinson's, especially younger people all of a sudden that come down with Parkinson's. I would highly think that it has something to do with the vaccinations that they've taken, and they need to be paying attention no different than you are with the children. There is some massive thing going on. And of course, you know, I write about this in my research, and I wrote about it in my books, Beguiled. You know, that it was all written in the stones. I mean, literally, if we look at the God stones that are up in the Georgia God stones that are located in Elberton, Georgia, they're specifically telling us they're wanting to maintain humanity under a certain number because they want to balance it out with nature. So if you start looking at this and look who's behind the people that do this kind of thing, they're all connected to the vaccination programs. They are the big wigs. They are the people who are making, making the things happen, and then trying to have a way to fix it, but they're making money off of it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if that's the case, you know, they don't want us to find an answer. It's like all the amount of money that goes into cancer research. I mean, literally, we have these, you know, cancer relays that happen in our communities every year. They raise huge amount of money, and then you just don't see anything really happening. I'm like, where is all this money going? Because there's a lot of money being raised. And the more that you deal, you know, you kind of deal in with finding out where does raised funds go, you find so much corruption. And, you know, I see all these royal families and stuff, and they're always doing these huge charities, and they're doing this and the other. And then when you start really finding out, well, where is the money really going? And is there anything really being done to make this better? Or with all the, I mean, if you stop and think, all the technology that we have and all the specific medicines that we have, we as Americans are more sicker than some of our countries that are so poor that don't have all these medicines. So what is that telling you? That something in the medicines are making us sicker. Yeah. And yet, you know, the World Health Organization is out running around wanting us to raise money. You know, if you go down and you buy a flu shot, well, they'll give a flu shot to somebody over in Africa. And I'm like, oh my gosh, we don't need a flu shot here, much less do we need to be giving somebody a flu shot in Africa. And, you know, when I did my first book, Antichrist, the Cloned Image of Jesus Christ, I started talking about hot viruses. And that was something that I had never heard anyone talk about, especially in end-time prophecy kind of things. You talk about things like the plagues, but nobody was, like, bringing up the names of the particular problems that could occur. And when I started doing that and began to see that there were hot viruses all over the world, and then started looking into, like, how did AIDS come about and how did, you know, find out that there was some vaccination programs that had been going on, and that these vaccination programs had these things that were tainted within the viral medicine that they were giving people, that they were not, well, they would say that they were not aware that there was a problem with them, but I fully believe they knew all the time that there was a problem with them. And it goes even back to most all of us as children received the polio vaccination. And you know, there's been a real question in the polio vaccination that we all received as children, was there something in there that was going to set up cancer? Because the amount of cancer that has increased in what I would call the baby boom society, most all of us had the original polio vaccination, you know, that formed a little scab that was on your arm. There's just a lot of little things that don't add up to the point that you have to go back and say, well, how does this all pan out? What is the goal of people knowing that these plagues are out there? They take them and they tweak them and make them change up, and so that the DNA changes itself, so you can't go after it. And we're seeing a lot of the, you know, the viruses and bacteria that are growing in hospitals now that are antibiotic resistant, or they have nothing that will go after them. And if the reason is that the DNA within that particular organism will actually change, and because it changes, you cannot continue to use the same antibiotics, no good anymore. And that's one thing that I'm fighting with my husband right now, because he has something called Pseudomonas aeruginosa, which is in the lungs, like cystic fibrosis patients, where it colonizes, and then antibiotics get where they won't kill it, and you can't get to it, and it manifests itself. It hides within the secretions of the lungs, and you can't get rid of it. So we're seeing more and more of this because there's a goal yeah, we're spending all these X amount of dollars in health care, but we're not finding answers. We're not getting rid of the problems. In fact, they're getting worse. And so now you can go out and look at, like I do, look at the world in itself. And I've been trying to explain this to people in my books, even back in the Beguile series with these three volumes that I've done. I even went back, you know, back, like I say, in the first book that I did, Antichrist, Climbing of Jesus Christ, and then the second book that I did with Eden, The Knowledge of Good and Evil, 666. And I tried to expose that these things around our earth are getting to be major problems. I mean, whether it be the first thing that I brought up a long time ago is about the genoflagellate, which was a type of protozoa that lived inside water that was also not only an organism like a real live organism, but also kind of a plant organism. But in the process of it, it was causing problems within estuaries, in which these estuaries would become like full of algae blooms, and then the algae blooms would cause a type of neurotoxin in the air. And then if you were in that area, you became sick. Well, you went down to the doctor, and he had no idea. He thought you had a flu symptom or whatever, but you were being actually poisoned by your environment, and nobody was saying anything about it because it might bring down what the state of, let's say, North Carolina was going to be making if the people found out we can't fish in the estuaries because you're going to get sick and it's a neurotoxin. But yet they had our government officials out there trying to figure out how to grow that neurotoxin because it was a great neurotoxin. They could use a neurotoxin gas against an enemy. So it's like there's this double standard, there's this double speak that's been going on for a long time as to what's really happening to the world. And the more that I've researched this, it's very scary because it's very real and it's getting very bad.
Yeah. Let me ask you this. First, I'm going to, you know, Aldous Huxley wrote, there will be in the next generation or so a pharmacological method of making people love their servitude and producing dictatorship without tears, so to speak, producing a kind of painless concentration camp for entire societies so that people will, in fact, have their liberties taken away. And I would include one of those liberties is the freedom, the liberty to actually worship Jesus Christ, to worship Yahweh, to believe in Yeshua. But anyway, he goes on to write, in fact, to have their liberties taken away from them, but will rather enjoy it because they will be distracted from any desire to rebel by propaganda or brainwashing, or brainwashing enhanced by pharmacological methods. And this seems to be the final revolution. It seems to me, Doctor, that they are actually trying to create a full society of people who are incapable of critical thinking into the fact that they are being enslaved, being put behind bars so they can't see the bars. Is this a manifestation of what some people want to call the satanic matrix, the Luciferian matrix? Are they trying to separate everybody from God, or do you even have the ability to think about Yeshua and Yahweh?
Yes, and I really do expose that in this Beguile series, because what I found, you know, when the Bible talks about sorcery, you know, we've heard the word sorcery, and we don't really realize that that word, when you carry it back into, the Hebrew and Greek translations, it's talking about pharmaka. I mean, it's really a word for using and inducing a change in a body to bring about satanic control over it. And sorcery was one of those things that was used in biblical days, but it's the same thing as pharmaca, as in other words, pharmacy, as far as drugs and that kind of thing. If you think back even in the days when the shamans would have the drum beats, and they would get to doing these drum beats, and then they would start using these herbs and things to breathe while they were doing that. They were bringing themselves up into a frenzy, drug state, drunken state, to experience something that was not of God. Because when we look back and see in the Bible about the oracle sites and about how these people channel these mediums, that they were absolutely bringing something within their bodies that was not them. In other words, they were speaking in a tongue that they did not know, or they were speaking in a deep voice, or they were just not them. They were actually channeling something through their bodies. And, you know, we were warned that that was not the thing to do. The Bible never tells us that it's not possible. It says it is possible. But when you do that, then you're bringing something into the body that's going to control the body. And, you know, when Jesus was here and he walked the earth, one of the first things he did was cast these demonic beings out of people. And, you know, when you look at the biblical scripture, it specifically shows you somebody that's having a, you know, like fits They're living among the tombs. They're doing all these crazy kind of things that we typically would say, well, they're having some type of seizure. Or we use it, you know, well, they're just psychotic and they don't know what they're talking about. Or they're schizophrenic and they're hearing voices and they need to be put away. The more that research that I've done in those areas, I've come to understand that, yeah, they are hearing something. Schizophrenics are very much hearing something. And there's a reason that they could be hearing something from a scientific basis. The pineal gland, which I talk a lot about in my Beguile series, Volume 2, is a very real gland that actually is in everybody's head. And it sits in the very forefront of your head. And that particular gland is a very workable eye in every lizard on Earth. And that's very interesting to me, that it's very workable. And when you go back and you look at the Eastern religions throughout history, they were always talking about bringing the serpent up the spine through their kundalini exercises, their yoga, and they were becoming illuminated. But what happens is, the more people, if you expose it and the more you look into it, you find that this illumination is not illumination of God, it's not a being of being with God, but it is opening yourself up to a spiritual manifestation that does exist in the lower realms of this world. And I think that's the thing, is that we are dealing with something that we cannot normally see on an everyday basis. We're opening ourselves up when we do things like that, when we practice yoga or meditation and we try to raise the serpent up the spine. And I've tried to explain that this is very, very sad, and it's a very scary thing, because what people don't realize, if you cross-section the brain, and I show this in my research, that looks like the very Ark of the Covenant, where the brain hemispheres will be in a certain area that looks like the Ark of the Covenant with the wings of the cherubim. And then the mercy seat that sits in the center there, that it would be like the pineal gland. And the thing about the pineal gland is that it is a very workable gland. It's a very, very workable gland that has a lot of control over our bodies that we don't sometimes realize the amount of hormones and the processing of what goes on in those hormones. The thing that I found most interesting about it when I started doing research was how that gland and its function had been really hidden from the public view of understanding it as something that was capable of maybe you being controlled at a distance or something controlling you. And when I began to expose this, that this little gland is not only there in your head, but it's like like your radio. It can receive information and it can transmit. So it's a it can do both. It can receive and it can transmit. And the reason is the gland is like, it has like a little quartzness to it. And just like your transistor radio would have a quartz and be able to pick up the radio waves, it can do the same thing. Well, the most interesting thing about that is, if you go back in history, you can see the archaeological record of what I would call the fallen angels. Like if you go back into the Sumerians and you see these huge drawings of buildings, you know, of beings on the side of buildings, especially in the Middle East, that they were holding something that looks like a pine cone in their hand.
Right.
And they had these wings. They were half men and half looked like they were serpent, like scaly. So that's telling you that they were of Satan. And they would have these pine cones in their hands, and they would be pushing them at the forehead of something, you know. And then they would have these little boxes in their hands, almost like they had some kind of telluric energy, which I have shown in my work, in all of my work, all of my books, about how these megalithic structures all around the world are built on ley lines.
Yeah,
they are garnering something from the earth that gives them some significant power. And so when you look at this, you can't say, well, these people were idiots. They were very intelligent, and it goes all the way back to when we see about the Tower of Babel. Why was that such a bad thing after the flood? It's because they were reinstituting all the things that had been before the flood that God had wanted to get rid of, and that was to try to really manipulate mankind in the flesh of mankind so that mankind did not really exist. And that's why you had, you know, Noah, and it says that he was pure in his lineage, and that is why his family was put on the ark along with the clean more clean than unclean animals to be able to replenish the earth and kind of get away from that. But what happened was, after the flood, I show how the DNA was reconstituted and how there were certain parts of Ham's lineage that went back, and you know, of course, Nimrod and the power of Babel and all that that happened in those areas was to bring back this same capability. And all of it had to do with this placing of this thing on the forehead and these little handheld things. And when you look at that, and then you look at how the pyramids were all designed, and that these things were laid out across the world. I mean, if you're not intelligent, you would not know that these lines even existed. I mean, it took science forever. And I guess we can go back and look at Nikola Tesla, and I have a whole chapter on him in my book, Eden, about how he was able to use Earth energies to produce electricity that would be free. If today we were able to use the technology that Tesla had, we would be paying for electrical bills. We wouldn't be paying for gasoline. We would have these little boxes, and our cars would run, and our homes would run, and it would be free energy. But the big guys that didn't like having the Rothschilds and the Rockefellers and J.P. Morgan, they all met over Cumberland Island, or Jekyll Island, that's not too far from where I live, years ago, to try to figure out how do we manifest electricity so we make money off of it. And they condemned Tesla and took him and just made him into a fool and went underground with his technology. No doubt in my mind that they did that and used it to their benefit in some of the black budgets that we fund today that we don't know what we're funding with our tax money. But at the same time, he was exposing this energy that I fully believe that all your megalithic buildings all over the world were possessing. I even talk about in my book Eden about the Gothic cathedrals that the Knights Templar built all over, the foreign lands, in such a way that they were laid out like the Milky Way. They formed a galaxy kind of thing on the ground. That, in other words, they mimicked the heavens and the earth with these cathedrals.
As above, so
below. As above, so below. I expose that.
Come on, Doctor. We're going to come up on a break here. And when we come back, I want to digress just a little bit, because I find it interesting that even our medical symbol within this allopathic healthcare system.
Oh, yes.
This allopathic conspiracy has the serpent. And I also find it interesting. I want to ask you, and I'll get your answer on this on the break, if you've done any research into the backbone and how it relates to that pineal gland, because obviously we see in ancient Egypt they all had the serpent on their heads, on their headdresses. But I also find it very interesting that we have 33 vertebrae, and then there's 33 degrees of Freemasonry, and how that's all connected. Obviously, we know Freemasonry at the high levels. We have satanic Luciferian orders, and they're doing awfully strange things. So when we come back, I want to talk about that, and I want to talk more about your books, and I want to give you a chance to let everybody know where they can go and get your books. Because I think most of these need to be read, because your research is so in-depth. And I'm just going to give you the floor, because you know far more than I do. So when we come back, we're going to be talking about the Freemasons. We're going to be talking about the vertebrae. We're going to be talking also about the pineal gland. And, you know, I said recently on a post, and people were like, now I'm confused. Opening your pineal gland or the third eye is not the thing you want to do, because quite frankly, and I want to get Dr. Joye's opinion on this too, with all this Wi-Fi and these Gwen Towers and the chemtrails, they're opening us to actually be controlled, to all become schizophrenic,
right,
to all hear voices. So it's very, very interesting to me. When we come back on the Awakening Liberty Show, my guest, Dr. Joye, we're going to explore, we're going to go way down the rabbit hole here. So everybody stay tuned. The Awakening Liberty Show is going to be right back.
No one can pretend the future. Still a one step from us. No one can bend the stars. Half of the workers use a telephone.
This is Truth Frequency Radio.
The wicked ones, obviously under heavy Masonic influence.
Ha 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 ha! Hi, everyone. This is Sean from the Awakening Liberty Show. Are you and your family prepared for an emergency? Have you ever thought about investing in food and water storage? Well, if you have, I urge you to check out my one-stop prepper shop. AwakeningLibertyStore.com carries the full line of Legacy Premium, non-GMO, made-in-USA emergency food storage and survival gear. Folks, I've tried them all, and Legacy Premium is the best I've found. Boasting the lowest cost per pound, the lowest cost per calorie, and the largest serving size in the industry, Legacy Premium is simply the best. Not to mention it was voted best tasting in blind taste tests, and I personally concur. Shop AwakeningLibertyStore.com and use coupon code PATRIOT for a special listener discount or call me personally at 775-276-4046. Once again, AwakeningLibertyStore.com. And welcome back to hour number two of the Awakening Liberty Show right here on truthfrequencyradio.com, your protection from deception all across America, all around the world. The number to call in is 866-37-TRUTH. Again, that number is 866-378-7884. Real quick, the Awakening Liberty Store, we got a big sale going on for truthfrequencyradio.com listeners. Go to AwakeningLibertyStore.com, check out the entire line of Legacy Premium non-GMO, made-in-USA emergency food storage, survival gear, water storage, filtration. We got Arctic Dome greenhouses. We got non-GMO and heirloom sea vaults. Go check it out and use coupon code 54901 again for Truth Frequency Radio listeners. 54901, get 10% off your entire order. Go to AwakeningLibertyStore.com and check out all of my products. Also, today, you know, we've got... there were some great ads here with that whole thing with the troll ad. I hope you guys heard that. You know, I'm sitting back behind my microphone today, my very expensive microphone. But anyway, today we've got Dr. Joye on the show, and she knows so much about what is going on in the world. Dr. Joye, before the break, we were talking about the pineal gland and the third eye, and we were also talking about how the medical symbol in and of itself for this allopathic healthcare conspiracy that we see happening here has ties to not only Freemasonry with the backbone, but also ties to old serpent worship, obviously Satan and Luciferianism. Can you expand on that a little bit more?
Well, you know, the thing that just like we mentioned before going into the break is that the pineal gland just has so much capability that has been hidden from the true world to know what's going on. I mean, it's just, I guess when I started doing the research on the pineal gland and just saw how much had been kind of hidden from public view, you find that there was a reason behind it, because it's easier to put people away and say they're not hearing voices, and they're sick and they're psychotic, instead of just trying to realize what are they really hearing, or are we tapping into something? And like you mentioned, the fact that there are these bands around Pharaoh's heads that have a serpent and a vulture in front of them, and that is located right over the pineal gland of the Pharaoh, and they're using gold, which is a type of conductor. And then the fact that these megalithic buildings that they, you know, that they utilized, whether it be the Egyptians or the people that lived in South America and in Middle America, there's so much that corresponds to each other, because all these people were involved with something that was called a feathered serpent. And if you look at all the archaeological findings that we have that are on record, it shows clearly that these people were intelligent, that they were using some type of technology that far exceeds anything that we have today, because we cannot go out and build the pyramids like they built the pyramids in the perfect state of those blocks and move those blocks like they have lined all that stuff up. But the fact that under those buildings, and like I mentioned, even the Gothic cathedrals that are all over, Eastern Europe and that kind of thing, you're just amazed that the crypts that were built by these Knights Templar are over those same ley lines, perfectly over them. So, you know, the Gothic cathedral is, even though you think it's to worship you know, people going there to worship for Jesus. Excuse me, they're huge actual instruments, and I explain how they're all finely tuned, just like the sarcophagus in the Great Pyramid. They're tuned to these perfect notes, and they have a resonance that when you get in them, and if you hum and do like people do when they sit and chant, bringing the serpent up the spine, that they are absolutely affecting the pineal gland. And the fact that this, like you mentioned before we went to break, that our medical establishment has been using, you know, this two snakes entwined on this shaft. And at the top of it is this little round thing, which is the pineal gland. And those two snakes are absolutely raising the serpent up the spine. It's like the tree of life, the knowledge of good and evil. It's a terrible thing, but when you think about, like I was mentioning, that if you cross-section the brain and it looks like the Ark of the Covenant, and the Bible says that, that God created us in His image and that we are in His image as a temple, and you think about the way the temple was set up and how they put the temple in the temple, in the holiest part of the temple, you put the Ark of the Covenant, well, that would be right in the middle of our foreheads. It would be perfectly centered there. So if mankind is in God's image and we are like His temple, then if you have this, like you say, the spine running to 33 levels up into that area, if you bring the bottom of that, which is bringing the serpent up the spine, you're putting the serpent in your Holy of Holies. What is more worse than that? I mean, what is more, a terrible thing to do to your body, because what you're doing is you're putting the serpent on the Ark of the Covenant, where the holy blood of Jesus was put, you know, to save us from our sins. So we have to really stop and think, if you do this and you think about when the priest, when they would go in to the Holy of Holies, they were supposed to be pure and holy and that kind of thing, that you're supposed to keep your Holy of Holies, your pineal gland, as pure and holy as you can keep it. But the problem is that Satan knows, there's some of us like you and I that know this, and that we're going to figure out what's going on, because a long time ago when they initiated people into these secret societies and stuff, they carried them into these crypts that were in these Gothic cathedrals, if you were going to be indoctrinated when you were a Knight Templar into Luciferian doctrine. They would take you down to these crypts, and you would do the meditation, and you would go from, each one had a chakra point. In other words, it was laid out on the earth, just like your body has the chakra in your spine, so that you would start at the base, in the serpent area, and you would work to the next level, which would be to the next Gothic cathedral, that would move you up on the chakras all the way up to actually Roslyn Chapel, which was the one that was designated as the most holy, holy place, where the pineal gland and our brain would be located. Roslyn Chapel is that place. And even in Roslyn Chapel, you have what they call the angel that's sitting there with the three fingers that look like they're hitting a certain chord. Well, it's a certain resonance, and that resonance abides in the crypt that's below the chapel there. And most people that go into it, they say, it gives me this weird, eerie feeling, because it's almost like there's a mixture between good and evil. Well, there is. Hey. It's like hiding behind sheepskin. It's like, you know, up on top, everything looks like it's for God and for Jesus, and then what's under it is something that is literally vibrating evil into your body, and that if you open yourself up to it, then the pineal gland is being affected. So if you can induce indoctrination that way and they become Luciferian indoctrinated, then that was the goal of the secret societies in their highest levels, was to indoctrinate you. And what most people don't understand is when you know, join like a secret society and you move on up, when you get to like 32nd or 33rd degree, depending on which facets that you get involved with, they ask you, you know, well, you're at the top now, and do you believe in God and Jesus, or, you know, whatever. Well, if you don't believe in God and Jesus, they have another door they take you through that goes to levels even higher on up. And the more blue blood you are, then you get into the skulls and bones societies, because you can't get into those societies unless you have the blue blood status to allow you in there. Because there's where the kings and the kings and queens make their puppets for running the world. And that's why we know now, if you do the historical lineages of presidents and you know, parliamentarians and things like that across the world, you find that there's a connection. There's usually a connection to a lineage that they're all part of. And that's all been established, because if the kings and queens don't run the world, they have pawns to do it for them. So when you indoctrinate your pawns, you use those that are in the lowest levels but have a lineage that does have indoctrination from those lineages. And then you use that to the purpose of being able to control the masses of people that are out there. And the more that you can use the pineal gland to do that in today's world, the more that we can be manipulated and used and made believe things that aren't real. And that's when you get into the pineal gland can be manipulated to such a point that you can massively hallucinate people and get them all to do bad at the same time.
Dr. Joye, is this the great deception that we are living in right now?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Because I think that's one reason why when I sat down and I finished my research, I wanted to know, well, you know, Lord, I prayed. I said, what do you want me to name the series, you know, these three-book series? And it was, Beguile was like, boom. And I thought, but most people never heard the word Beguile or didn't really understand what it was. But, of course, it was what the serpent did to Eve in the garden. And I was like, well, you know, really, that's when it all began. We began being beguiled right there in Eden by the same thing that's just right here with us now, and he's still distracting and distorting and making us believe one thing when it's something totally different. And that the elite that rule the world, we think they're here for our good, and we find out that when Jesus was here, you know, Satan offered him the kingdoms of the world. In other words, Jesus said, you know, this is my kingdom is not of this world. So when you immediately know who's running the world, it's Satan's pawns that are running the world. So yes, we are living in an age of such great and enormous deception, and it's destroying our churches. I mean, churches are getting into this practice of sitting and chanting. They're bringing the serpent of the spine sitting in their, you know, in their churches, and I'm like, oh my gosh. You can't do that. The Bible tells you, it says, do not do anything. Do not even do prayers and repetition. The Bible tells us not to do that, because repetition is like a drum beating. And I'm a musician, so I just know this. If you beat your drum at a certain beat and you stay at a certain beat, there are beats that you can put a person in a room and keep that beat going in their head at a certain beat. It'll drive them crazy.
Yeah,
Your body is a temple that has a resonance. Every one of us are singing. Every part of our DNA is different. Your DNA is different than my DNA, but your DNA has a song just like my DNA has a song. Everything is singing. Everything alive is singing. Every planet out there, the sun, everything has a resonance. The earth has its own resonance. And when you start distorting those resonances, you cause infection, you cause distortion of brain waves, you start distorting circadian rhythms, you make people sick. And that's why we're seeing, like, for example, fish, you know, shoring themselves. They're losing the ability to know where everything is. Everything, in other words, I think resonance is changing everything. The harmonics are being completely destroyed on Earth. And the intent is through the pineal gland. The pineal gland has the capability of our reasoning. It has the capability of our true functioning. And if you remove that gland, you know, either through, you know, things that they've done playing around with the pineal gland, what you find is that you get a person that has no responses. They are like a robot. In other words, they can function, but they don't have anything like the normal human being has with emotions and maybe free will. So if Satan, and I actually named that a part of my book, was it, that it's Satan's final frontier, that the pineal gland is Satan's final frontier, because he first started indoctrinating these people. He promised them to be like gods. You know, that was the thing. But you can look in the old things that we have unearthed, let's just say down in South America, even most recently, where they, you know, they found that there were tunnels up under the huge pyramids that are there. And then when they uncovered this stuff, they were saying, well, this was helping people become gods. Well, the Bible tells us we can never become God. What was the thing that was told to Eve? Oh, you can become like God if you eat this fruit. This is the same game
right.
that's being played today as it was back then, that, oh, we can do this, and you can make yourself this, and you can make yourself that, and let's take all these whatever things to, and pharmaca, to, and sorcery, to make all this stuff happen. But what it is it's dumbing and numbing and dumbing us down to the point of control. And once you lose that ability to have free will, then you are no longer truly human. And if God had wanted to create us as robots, which he could have done, and then nothing would have happened in the Garden of Eden, they would have continued to love him, and he would have never had free will to go in any other direction, but he did not do that. So Satan, to be able to control humanity, has got to control that gland. And now that, I've been trying to expose the fact that it is a gland that's workable. I saw this in my research when I started looking at people who sleepwalk, and they can walk through a house with their eyes closed and never bump into anything. They can walk out in their yard and never fall in their swimming pool. Their eyes are closed. And when I started seeing that when you do hypnosis, that people can write their names inside of lines and their eyes are closed, something is seeing.
Right.
They're seeing. So this gland is working. And somebody has known it's been working for a long, long time. So now it is that they're going to go after it. And the fact that we've got satellite capability, we've got cell phone capability, we've got cell phone towers, everything is running on these ley lines that these serpent people knew all these years ago. I mean, we are sitting ducks. And they're just waiting for us to either to try to revolt, or if we try to tell people, look what's happening to you. They've got things in place. It's just like with the rioting and things that's going on. If you take and you incite something, most people won't do anything. But then they think if everybody else is doing it, they'll jump on the bandwagon. And then that's how you get a frenzy established. And then things happen, and then they can force us under martial law, force us to take, a chip, force us to do these things. I mean, I show in my work that, the United States, unfortunately, is a corporation that's owned by the British. Whether we want to believe it or not, the Revolutionary War and all the stuff, even with the Civil War, it was controlled by the British. They own our money. They own our lawyers. We're under maritime law. All of our attorneys have to have a bar that goes to the City of London. The Rothschild on the money. I mean, it's like one big step of all control. And we're the little peons that they've played around with for as long as they can. And if we get a little bit unruly and we don't just like bow to them and let them do their little, what I call cobra waves, or they do little hands that look like a little snake waving at you, if you don't wave back and if you don't love them, if you don't bow down to them, they have got things in place to literally destroy us.
Right.
And you can look at the Guidestones. You can see, what's written up there in Elberton, Georgia, out in the middle of a field. I mean, it's just a cow pasture where they put this stuff up. I'm like, there's a game, and it's all been a part of this game. It's all been an agenda, actually, from the Garden of Eden. And that's why when I was doing this research, I had to go back to the Garden of Eden and establish what happened there for you to be able to see how Satan, this old serpent, was right there, and the promises he made to Eve to be like God, manipulating the mind, and he's still doing that with humanity. And the sexual connotations and bringing people down, the pedophilia, the destruction of innocence, has just manifested itself right now worldwide.
Absolutely.
And as we become a cashless society, and we don't have our money in our pockets, and we can't function without a Walmart or our electricity, then we are sitting ducks for our control capability and a mass hallucination that is beyond imagination. So I think it's important for people to see that some of the things that you think you're enjoying may be brainwashing you. And I've tried to explain that in my books, too, because a lot of people enjoy playing these video games. You enjoy listening to certain kinds of music. I mentioned that there's some music that you can't get out of your mind. You go at night, you're like, oh, I can't get that out of my brain. Well, let's look at like people like Prince and Michael Jackson. They could not come down at night. They could not sleep. I'm a musician and I write music, and I know that there are certain chords that you can use that will affect people. I've had friends that were musicians in rock bands and would say that, whoa, we hit this chord and we change this up a little bit, people's eyes get funny and they just lock into you. Resonance, harmonic resonance, again, is a very controlling aspect of humanity. So when you find yourself, you can't get something out of your head or something's just not letting you rest, it's locking on to you. Literally, it is affecting your harmonic resonance. It is changing you. So you need to be careful about certain video games. I feel certain that some of the shootings that we have seen have been through Manchurian candidates, that they have been playing these games on the Internet and have gotten themselves involved in some of this, what I call eye dosing, where you hear one thing through one ear and one frequency through another, and it forms a phantom beat inside your head. And that those beats can induce drug-like capability. In other words, instead of taking cocaine, you can make your brain think it is on cocaine, and it will react as if you had taken it. So there's all this stuff out there that if you play with, and the Bible's telling you, you start playing with this stuff, this sorcery, it's all sorcery, it's going to be the downfall of not only you, but it will be the downfall of society.
Yeah.
And I think right now we're seeing this happen worldwide, and it's going to continue to escalate because people are not being educated. They're not willing to turn it, you know, to tune into radio shows like yours, and we're not able to get on like NBC, ABC, and CBS and scream it at the top of our lungs, look what's happening, because guess who owns those those big-time, you know, networks? Guess who owns the big-time book publishers? Guess who owns, you know, the people that do mass media? It's the people that are controlling us.
Yeah.
And they're not going to let the word get out. I mean, literally, I was on a radio show a couple of years ago, and this was before anybody was talking about the pineal gland, okay? And I had explained to them, they'd asked me what I was going to talk about, and asked me to come on the show to, you know, go through my book, and so we started on something, and it led me to start talking about the pineal gland. And I was politely cut off. Thank you very much, Dr. Joye. Bang. And, you know, everybody was like, where did she go? She's just been on for like 3 hours. What happened? And the host never said, well, Dr. Joye, you know, we whatever. They had somebody that came right on, like, and didn't say thank you for coming on the show or whatever. And people were like sending me things. Did you pass out? You know, are you okay? Are you sick? But I was like, well, what did I say wrong? What made them want me to be off that show, like, right then? And I know a couple of friends I have were, you know, listening back to the show, and they were like, well, you're just talking about the pineal gland. It was something pretty interesting. And I'm like, oh, my gosh. As long as they want you to know the pineal gland should be something that you could bring the serpent up the spine, if I had been talking about the New Age version, if I'd have been saying, oh, yes, by the way, if you do this, you're going to be illuminated. You're going to see, you know, these lights, and you're going to hear all this stuff. I would have never been cut off. But the moment that I said, you're bringing the serpent up into your holy of holies, you're able to be controlled in that gland. Oh, my gosh, there's the problem. Now I'm telling you the other side of the story, kind of like Paul Harvey used to say, and here's the rest of the story.
Oh, I loved him.
And when I did too, because what happens, you would hear something, and then he would tell you the whole story, and it was like, oh, amazing. Well, that's kind of what I try to do about the pineal gland. Is that here's all this information that's been out there forever and ever and ever and ever in regard to the third eye and it being workable and da-da-da-da-da, but then let's look at the science behind it. Let's look at what the Bible's saying about it. And let's say, if it is your holy of holies, then you are putting Satan in God's place. And what is the greatest abomination, or what is the thing that the Bible tells you is the most, I guess what I would say, terriblest sin ever, and that is to totally turn your back on God. And when you put the serpent in your holy of holies, I can't think of a worse abomination to say, I'd really rather have him there than you.
Yeah. I know.
Because I think
I know for myself, I would much rather live under the rules and laws of Yahweh instead of going over this Luciferian satanic doctrine, because I completely agree with you. And all the information you're saying to me is resonating with me, because so much of what's going on in the world, the immorality, the depravity, these shootings and people going, and some of those I do believe they're MK Ultra. Some of them I believe are absolute hoaxes, obviously to push a gun control agenda. But we are under attack from so many different angles, not just the pharmacological and the allopathic healthcare system, but under our GMO foods, under the chemtrails. I really believe that this aluminum is going in and affecting our blood-brain barrier, and it is making us where we cannot think. It's also making us susceptible to suggestion. This is absolutely crazy, and I've told people this before. If you haven't figured this out yet, I mean, God is waiting for us to come to Him through free will, or we are all going to usher in the dominion of Lucifer in this whole drama designed to basically figure out whether the laws of Lucifer will be able to basically rule the physical realm that we are living in. And this just absolutely blows me away, because God is waiting for us to turn to Him, because if we don't, we're going to cause our own extinction. And if we turn in and usher in the Luciferian order, the satanic matrix, if we usher this in, we will be turning our backs on God. That is the ultimate sin. And quite frankly, I've been down the road of drugs and alcohol. I've been in the darkness, and I do not want to be separated from God for eternity. That's where my focus is, and I think that's where everybody's focus is, should be on the eternal, because there is salvation in Yahshua and the Most High God, Yahweh. We'll be right back with my guest, Dr. Joye.
Are TFR.
My faith in destiny is all I need to prevail.
Truth Frequency Radio.
I'll bust it one time. Truth and liberty. Frightening the world order and the tyranny. The Awakening Liberty Show with Sean Caron.
And welcome back to the Awakening Liberty Show right here on truthfrequencyradio.com. And this show is just flying by. We got a great guest today, Dr. Joye. And Dr. Joye, I was trying to put something into words before the end of the last segment. And I'm not a very eloquent guy. I'm just a radio host, and I try to do the best I can. But this was from a friend of mine's book, and it says, basically, humankind's unexplained plight is analogous to an experimental drama being played out before the angelic realm, where the outcome will condemn or justify the angelic rebellion. Will all of humankind rebel, bow to Lucifer, and cause its own extinction? Or will the elect still choose God through free choice, even while the mainstream of humankind ushers in the dominion of Lucifer? This is a drama designed to prove whether or not the ways of Lucifer should be allowed to dominate the physical universe, a drama predetermined to play out over 6,000 years, beginning with the fall of Adam. To me, when I'm asking, have you figured it out yet? That's what makes sense to me. That's what seems to be going on. And that's why so many of us, like myself, who were embedded in the music industry and all of that, you know, I love music. I'm a musician just like you are, Dr. Joye. But, you know, I was down a very, very dark road in that, and it almost killed me. And that really is Lucifer's ultimate goal, is to get you to kill yourself. But, I mean, would you agree with this very eloquently put drama? He's basically laid out the drama that's occurring.
Yes, definitely. I mean, the thing about it, like I say, I did a whole chapter on that this pineal gland is Satan's final frontier, and being able to manipulate the mind, and mind control has been around for a long time. I know in the Beguile Volume 2, I even mentioned about that when I first started reading and trying to find out about how could the mind be manipulated and controlled, and I found work that was done by a guy named Jose Delgado, and he was a CIA psychologist. And back in 69, I'll read real quick what I wrote in my book that he actually said. It was in his book, Physical Control of the Mind Toward a Psycho-Civilized Society, was the name of the book. But what these are his words. Physical control of brain functions is a demonstrated fact. It is even possible to create and follow intentions, the development of thoughts and visual experiences, by stimulation, electrical stimulation of specific cerebral structures in the brain. Movements can be induced by radio command. Hostility may appear and disappear. Social hierarchy can be modified. Sexual behavior may be changed. And memory, emotions, and the thinking process may be influenced by remote control. Now, if you stop and think about what he's saying back in 1969 as a psychologist with the CIA, that they already knew that there was a way to physically control the brain functions at a distance, and that you could literally change a person's intentions, create intentions, develop their thoughts, change their visual experiences, and then electrically stimulate any cerebral structure in the brain, and that those movements could be induced by a radio command, which I'm telling you that pineal gland would pick up a radio wave. You might induce hostility. You can make it appear, disappear. You could change their social hierarchy, sexual behavior. I mean, stop and think about how sexual behavior is right now. Memory, and you find people going, I just can't remember anymore. I just can't think anymore. I just feel bad.
I walk
emotions and
forget,
and the thinking process.
I do that all the time. It's like, is this the chemtrails? What is this? Is this a food? You know, I'm changing my diet. That's terrifying, Dr. Joye, that they know they have that technology and that they can do that to us. And I see it going on. Obviously, you're talking about the sexual depravity. And then we got people wanting to change their genders and going through this whole surgical process. I mean, things have just gotten way out of control, out of hand, off the hook, crazy.
Well, you know, and knowing that that goes back to that time period, and like I say, when I started doing the research and seeing that this information had been kind of hidden from public view, and then when I tried to start exposing it, then the big guys don't want this exposed. They don't want people to know that you may be feeling the effects of what they're doing. It's kind of like, I used to example many times, it's like a frog. You can put him in water and slowly turn the temperature up, and he'll sit there and boil to death and never know that the water's gotten too hot for him to sit in there. That is what's happening to humanity. They're doing it at such a beguiled pace, a little slow pace, subtly along, that they're boiling us to death, and we don't even realize it until we're dead. Or we're non-functioning. And I think that's why the Bible tells us in the end of days that the time will be cut short, because if it's not, not even flesh could be saved. And that's what was happening in the days of Noah. The true flesh of humanity, the true DNA of what God created in flesh, was about to be totally annihilated. Today, the same thing's happening with the biotechnology, with the cloning, with all this capability of mixing everything. And that was the biggest abomination, I feel like, was that in the garden, like I said, everything that God created was seed after their kind. Apple trees were apple trees, peach trees were peach trees. You didn't have like a peach that tasted like an apple and a tomato that tasted like an orange. Everything was obvious after its kind, and it was the same thing. And the only thing that was different in that garden,
Dr. Joye, are you talking about the angelic,
good and evil?
Are you talking about the angelic sin, the angelic rebellion of Genesis 6, where
how the mixing happened? Because if not, then there would not have been any reason for the, you know, why, what caused the flood? It was these beings that God did not create in the beginning that was causing the problem. It was actually eradicating mankind as was created in Adam's lineage, as it was. So that's a very scary thing, because what we see now happening is all these manipulation of everything. Our bodies can assimilate the foods. These are not designed by God, you know, and I think that they're clogging the body, and the body can't eradicate certain things, and it's setting up cancer, and like you're talking about, if they're spraying the air with chemtrails. I mean, all the stuff, we were not designed to have that infiltrate our systems. And if it doesn't come to a stop, in other words, if there's not a point where God says enough is enough, and the Bible says he's going to do that, and the reason he's doing it, because if not, then flesh can't make it. In other words, the true human being cannot withstand it. And I think that we're seeing that. I think if you look around, I know recently had several people talk to me about how many people that had died in our area, and just kind of really freak things. It wasn't like they were old and whatever. It was like weird little things happened. And they said, do you notice how many people are dying? I'm like, do you notice how many fish are dying? Do you notice how many birds are dying? Do you notice how many cows are dying and antelopes? And, you know, the more you look at this, the Bible tells us at the end of days it's going to be like a woman in travail, that these things, these signs, yes, people die, yes, birds die, but it's going to be like a woman having a baby. The signs get closer and closer, and they get bigger and bigger, and the pain gets worse and worse until she delivers the baby. Well, I truly believe that we're at that hour. We're at that midnight hour that something's going to happen, because it cannot continue the way it is. If it does, everything becomes Luciferian, and I think that's why the Battle of Armageddon, I think that's why the wrath of God is poured out. I think that's why there's a catching away of people. I think that's why the 144,000 that are going to be left have to be sealed. Interesting enough, don't you think it's strange?
Yeah.
The Bible says the 144,000 have to be sealed in their foreheads. What is in your forehead? Your pineal gland. You know, and I've heard people say, "Well, I don't know why." You know, it's 12,000 of the 12 tribes, and that's who's going to be kind of left here. But they have to be sealed, because if they're not sealed, that gland is going to be so manipulated that you couldn't see the truth if it would hit you in the face.
And that's why.
Right now, we're seeing people being so numbed down they can't see the truth.
I see people, they're not even capable of critical thinking anymore. All they do is...
That's right.
I mean, it's hook, line, and sinker about everything that's going on in the world. And that's frustrating to me, because, you know, what bothers me, I guess, and maybe this shouldn't bother me, because somehow I seem to be immune to it to a degree. However, part of me would love to jump on board this new age kumbaya, everything peaceful, whole new age movement that they're trying to usher in, because it sounds great. But I look at the people who are involved, and they're obviously Satanists. They're obviously Luciferian, the Bohemian Grovers, and these pedophiles everywhere. So that makes me obviously question it. But again, is it because for me, is it because I know Yahshua? I know he's in my heart. I believe with every ounce of my being in that makes me immune to it? You know, what makes other people...
Well,
go ahead.
I think that it does. And the reason I say that is because the Bible tells us that the closer you draw to him, the closer he is to you. So it's like I've tried to explain about the pineal gland. It's like a party. It can become a party line. In other words, if you bring the serpent up in there and you're allowing the serpent to be in there with God, you're making your brain like a party line. You're kind of inducing a tree of good and evil within yourself without establishing good. And that's why God says, pray on good things. You know, in other words, stay away from evil. It tells you not to participate in evil. It's trying to warn you that if you give in, then evil is going to overcome you. It will literally overcome you, because it is so powerful. And I don't think people understand that this thing that we fight is very real, this satanic realm. It tells us that we do not, you know, fight in the world of flesh and blood. It says we're fighting principalities and high places. And this is a power that transcends anything that we have as far as our ability, because it can manipulate us. It can use, like I'm talking about, these radio waves and all this kind of stuff against our own bodies, and we don't even realize it's happening to us. So that's why I was saying earlier that you need to be very aware of the music you listen to and the games that you play and the things you get involved with, because if Satan can lure you into thinking, like you said, hey, wonderful thing, everybody's doing it, what a great place, if we can all be like John Lennon, you know, we all going to love, have peace and happiness here, and there's no hell below us and no heaven above us. Well, surprise, there is coming a day when everybody's going to know, and every knee is going to bow, when that sky busts wide open and the King of Kings stands there and says, you know, this is really real, guys. I created this. You're in my image. How dare you destroy this? And he is not going to be a nice guy. I understand God is love, and he wants us to love him. But a true parent, if they love a child, will punish their child to make them get back in order.
Yeah.
And he has his rules and regulations, and if people don't believe that, they need to read the book of Leviticus. I've always said if I lived back in the day, I would have never made it, because, I mean, I'm telling you, the laws that were established back then was to try to keep you holy and pure, every part of your flesh.
It was
to save you from Satan.
I was just reading Leviticus, and boy, that would not go over well. If we tried to impose those laws and regulations in today's society, oh my goodness gracious.
Yes, but when you understand that the flesh of what God created in the garden was so pure in itself, and that is how that Jesus was born, through that, to be able to save us all, even though we have been tainted with all this other stuff, and allow us to get back to paradise, you get to understanding that God wanted his true lineage not to mingle with these other people and not to participate in these things, because when you did that, it brought evil, it brought Satan, it brought the things that we see today are manifesting in every aspect of our lives. I mean, you cannot turn on the TV, you can't watch the news, you can't hear anything on the internet, Facebook, whatever, even your family and friends, the things that they're going through. You're just amazed that it's just turmoil, turmoil, turmoil. And if you don't have something, what I would say, credible and truthful to hold on to, and that be, you know, your mind on God, even though the days may get bad, and he's telling you they're going to get bad, and this is why they're going to get bad, because there's judgment coming. And for these people that want to run after the Pope and say, oh, yeah, we worship a God by a different name, you know, we all worship in the same God, that is a false statement in every aspect. It is a false statement. And if you will look at the religions of the world and how these other religions came about and how many serpents and snakes and all this stuff is involved with their stuff, you'll know immediately that you're on the wrong track. And you need to look at who came and gave their life so that even though we may have done things wrong, we may have sinned, that we can get back to paradise. Yeah. These other gods never promised somebody. They didn't die. They didn't do anything. You know, they're made up. And the more you find that out and you come to terms with it, you get the bigger picture that, like you say, this New Age movement of peace and love, it's a great thought process, but it will be peace and love if you're going in the right direction. If you're being manipulated into believing it's all going to be okay and you don't have to change and you don't have to have any conviction of your sin and you don't have to ask for forgiveness and you can just live your life, and as long as you're not hurting anybody, everything's just hunky-dory.
That's the antinomian.
Fooling yourself.
We see the antinomian pastors out there. I believe that they're actually leading up a lot of people astray as well. You know, and you mentioned be careful about what kind of music you listen to. Be careful about what kind of video games you play. I mean, even watching TV, Dr. Joye, we already know that the frame rates change your alpha wave.
Oh, yes.
Beta. I mean, you got to be careful.
Yes.
That's why I say turn off the TV.
Everything that can be electrically stimulating your brain, literally, you know, it's possible. I mean, and the thing about it is, you can have the TV off. You can be sitting in your home, and I know I have a lot of people who will write me or call me and say, you know, I hear this little hum sometimes. I just hear this constant little hum, and it's a low level hum, but it bothers me because I can hear this little hum. What do you think it is? Well, you know, we have to stop and think that something's changing the very frequency of the earth. And I think some of the booms that we've heard all over the world, that there's plates changing, there's tectonic things happening, you know, happening to the earth. And I think even that in itself can harm you. And even if it is, and even if all this is going on, the only thing that we have to look to save us is Jesus. I mean, literally, there is no other way but through him. I mean, we can't go and we can't do good and we can't be the best person in the world and we can't do all these things that the Bible has told us is wrong. And I know people don't like to hear that, but, you know, it tells us not to commit adultery. It tells us not to you have homosexuality in your life. It tells you not to do all these things. And it's not that you know, you're coming down on somebody hard. You're just telling them the truth. But unfortunately, people want to continue to do what they feel like is fun, and if they're not hurting somebody, instead of saying, what does the Word of God say? I mean, literally, like you were saying, you read Leviticus. If they didn't follow what God said, he killed them. He had his people kill them. You know, we think about how he swallowed up a whole group of people after he carried them through the Red Flood. I mean, you know, the Red Sea.
Yeah.
He doesn't put up with junk. He's not going to put up with junk. He is not going to put people back into paradise that he removed Satan and his angels from heaven for.
Right.
He's not going to do it. Right. He's just not going to do it. And while I think it breaks his heart, he has given us free will to choose. If we choose not to love him, then that's our choice. And when we stand before, and you'll have to stand before him, because it says, you know, biblically, scripturally, that he blew into Adam the breath of life, and we all have the spirit that comes into us and goes back to him for judgment. So you're going to have to stand before him, and you're going to have to hear and see all the things that you did and to justify it. And that's, you know, people say, well, I just don't believe that can happen. Well, it's funny to me that when I've done research on people who have near-death experiences or think they are about to die, that they'll say, boy, I just saw my entire life flash before, you know, my eyes. Well, I will tell you this. Under hypnosis, you can take people back to any day in their childhood. And I've seen this happen over and over again, where you can ask the question, on day so-and-so, what were you doing? And they'll say, well, I was sitting in Miss So-and-so's classroom in the second grade, and Johnny was sitting in front of me. Well, what's he got on? Well, he's got on blue jeans and red tennis shoes. And who's sitting behind you? Well, Susie's sitting behind me. What kind of dress has she got on? She got on a dress? She got on shorts? No, she has on a cute little dress, and it's got da-da-da-da-da. And they'll be talking while they're telling you that in a two-year-old voice. If you ask them to write their name on a piece of paper, they will write it like they were holding a big old pencil that we used to have a long time ago before they have what they have now, but it was a huge pencil. And they will write it like they are printing their name if they were in the second grade. So it tells you that everything in your brain is all there.
It's all there.
So you have to relive everything. It is all there.
I want to ask you about something, because this has been something that's bothered me here recently. A lot of people have been talking about this alleged Mandela effect, which I've been very skeptical of. However, one has been brought to my attention here recently that really bothered me, because when I was young, I was actually studying to become a priest. And people know that story. I kissed a girl at 13, my hair got curly, and I forgot all about that. But I remember studying the Bible, and in Isaiah, it talks about, you know, who did the lamb lie down with? And I remember it distinctly. I remember reading it distinctly as it being the lion. But now I go and open up my King James Version Bible, or even the NIV, and it's fox. Are you aware of this Mandela effect? I mean, is this just a mass consciousness?
Well, the lamb's going to lay down with the lion, and that's what the King James Version does say. So there is something, like you say, there's something really going on. But I had noted a long time ago when I'm a person who believes in having the books that I, in other words, when my research in the end of my books have a bibliography. I have all those books. I have read all those books. I had those books in my library. I'm a person who likes to hold the real truth and be able to research it and have it in my hand so that I know beyond a shadow of a doubt what I've written and where it came from, and who had researched it before me and before them and before that.
Excuse me, then you get the truth set up. I was corrected. It actually says the wolf. And I actually went and looked at this. I went and opened up my Bible, and it says the lamb lays with the wolf. And I remember it being
the lion.
And there's even a statue where the lamb is laying with the lion that has the Isaiah verse on it. So, you know, and people say CERN is manipulating reality, and they're actually changing copies of the Bible. You know, and somebody else mentioned the other
day. They are.
Yeah, this is bizarre.
They are changing copies of the Bible. Wow. And they are getting rid of all the books in our libraries. And this is something that I found out, like I said, a couple of years ago when I was trying to get certain books. The library has been asked to purge all these books, and they purged them. They got rid of them. They threw them in the trash. They burned them. So being able to go back and find true history has become a little bit of an issue. That allows them to rewrite history. And I believe that is what's going on, that they are rewriting it because you can't go back and find the original copies.
Right. Well, and people say that this is happening on a quantum level, which is just bizarre to me, because people are saying it's changing on their shelves. It's changing on their coffee tables, you know, and with what CERN is doing, just weird stuff. You know, who knows what's really going on? But I found that very it disturbed me when I'm going, I know the lamb laid with the lion and the wolf.
That's right. So, you know, if you stop and you really think about how manipulation, what did I read to you a while ago? In 1969, they were already saying that they had the capability of doing that. Imagine the technology that we have garnered in black budget since 1969 that can be used against the human capability of the brain. Mm-hmm. Just imagine, since 1969, all the things that we have learned and know about. So yes, I truly believe that what we sometimes think we might see may be a hallucination. It could be anything you can imagine being put in front of you. And I do think that a lot of the people who are being manipulated to do some of these terrible acts of violence, I truly believe, are either using some type of drug or either participating in something that is allowing the mind to be used in a negative way. And they may not even be aware of it. You know, they may not understand what is even happening to them. But I do believe that's Satan's final frontier, and that's how he continues to destroy society. Because if we continue to do shootings against policemen and they feel like we are getting out of control, they're going to put us under martial law. And my books explain all about the executive orders and how that was established and what maritime law is and how that means that, you know, you don't own your property, you are a tenant. I mean, I have it all listed in there. And what happens is they just send you down to probably the local post office and they put a number on you. They tell you what you're going to do and when you're going to do it.
Dr. Joye, tell
And you don't want to do it, they get rid of you.
Tell everybody where that you can get, they can get your books and your website real quick, because we're almost out of time, which this is too short of a show.
Well, my research is so, I've got so much in it. You know, we can already get to a little bit of it every time we have a show, but I appreciate you letting me do this. My website is www.drjoye, and it's DRJOYE. It's joy with an E .com. All my books and all the links and everything to my radio shows that I'll be doing or have done, as well as YouTube videos and my music, everything is there. And if you've got a question, my email is there, and I'd be glad to answer anything that you might have a question about if you'll email me. So hopefully you'll go out and get the books, and that helps me, because of my situation with my husband, be able to continue to do the research that I do. And I appreciate everybody that follows my research and listens to the shows and sends me information that they may have that they want me to know about. So I appreciate it.
Well, absolutely, and I would encourage everybody to go check out Dr. Joye's website. She's got all kinds of great information, and thank you again for being on the show, Dr. Joye. I'd love to have you on again sometime here in the near future. There is obviously, we are living in a great deception. There are so many things going on. It's absolutely crazy what's going on, and the Bible tells us that. In Revelations, there will be a great deception. I believe it's here. I believe it is now. I believe this is important, and people need to start paying attention. And if we don't start paying attention, we're going to lose. Coming up tomorrow at 2 o'clock, Carolyn Hamlet, we're going to be exposing the Illuminati. She's a former Illuminated one. We're going to be talking about her experiences as a child. She has come back to Christianity. And coming up next, Zen Garcia. And I will be on Zen Garcia's show, Secrets Revealed, on the 23rd. Everybody, may God bless you and keep you until I see you tomorrow.